Hi fellow birdies, welcome back to the channel. In today's video we're going to be trying out some brand new items from Taco Bell. Now these did come out a few weeks ago, but I'm just now getting around to doing them. But I'm not going to be doing all the brand new items from Taco Bell today, but I've selected about three new items that we're going to showcase. So I'm going to be getting the loaded taco fries, the new beefy potato flatbread taco, and a blue raspberry lemonade freeze. I can't wait to try these out. They sound really good just from the names. And I'm at the Taco Bell in Bartlett, Tennessee today. So let's go ahead and get in line and get that food.
Thank you for choosing Taco Bell. What can we make first for you today?
Hi, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing good. I was wondering if I could please have the beefy potato flatbread taco.
Okay, what else for you today?
I was wondering if I could also please have the loaded taco fries. And also I'd like to please have a regular blue raspberry lemonade. That'll be it, ma'am.
6:45, ma'am.
All right, thank you so much. There is something else I did bring along with me. I'm going to tell you guys about it soon, but I've got some peaches because we went to a orchard yesterday and with the family, and we picked a lot of peaches, so yeah. Alright, thank you.
Have a great day, ma'am.
You too, thank you. Alright, let's go find somewhere to park and try out these new items. Alright guys, I'm now parked and we're going to be trying out the new items. Now, let's see. It looks like I got the burrito instead, but that's okay. So they have the nacho fries burrito. And then I also got the flatbread beefy potato soft taco. All those look good. Like, look at that. Let's see the potatoes. Oh, I've always loved their potatoes. All right, let's go ahead and try out the flatbread taco. Like, look at that. Looks so good. Okay, so here we go. That beef is really, really flavorful. I can definitely taste the sauce. I think it's chipotle. I'm not sure. And then there's a potato. So, but yeah, like I was reading reviews and stuff of the flatbread tacos, and they kept saying that this one was better than the chicken one. So I wanted to try this one out. I might try the other one out next time. Gotta tell you, those potatoes are so good. One thing I've been meaning to do is like maybe try out some of the breakfast items sometime, but I hadn't really thought about it because they got really good crunch wraps and breakfast burritos, and they serve them with the hash browns and the Cinnabon Delights. Man, this takes a whole nother level. So like, yeah, like look at that. Dude's amazing. I really love the flatbread part too. It kind of really goes fits well with this combination. So they came out with these items I think a couple weeks ago, and like a whole bunch of new nacho fries items. Like they got the one with the burrito here, they got loaded taco fries as well. And I'm hopeful, you know, one of those other times I can get that. They didn't have them today, unfortunately. And they didn't have the blue raspberry drink either, so I just got that. But I always love a good Mountain Dew from Taco Bell. But I can see why this is so good. I'm saying that is a good flatbread. Really, 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 really good. Sorry. I'm just like really in love with the flatbread. Oh, wow, that tastes good too. The Baja Blast is definitely different than the regular Mountain Dew. Like it kind of reminds me a bit more of pineapple. It's got that pineapple mix in too and stuff. So, I love how I give this like an 8 out of 10, 8.5. I really, really like it. This would be good for like a snack. And I think the total cost of it was like only $1, but I would have to look at the receipt. Let me see. Yeah, the flatbread taco was only $1. The loaded fries burrito was $2.99, and the Baja Blast was $1.89. So all this together was only like $4.45. So pretty good value. Oh my god. Okay. Now, I'm not sure about this one. Like, I've sort of heard like mixed reviews about, but you know, I'm gonna go ahead and try it out anyway. So, here we go. Is the inside. It's not bad, but I do agree with the other reviewers who tried this, is that it probably could do without the lettuce. Like, the lettuce kind of takes away from the taste of it. But it's pretty flavorful, pretty good. But I never really imagined the idea of actually having nacho fries inside of a burrito. That's a really cool idea. So we're going to take another bite. And it's also got cheese inside as well. And it's got like, this thing is like loaded with a lot of fries. That is pretty good. I honestly do like the idea of it wrapped in a burrito. Like, one reviewer I watch a lot, Timmy's Takeout, he was actually saying that this was like the loaded taco fries just wrapped in a burrito. Like, it wasn't bad, but like, he would prefer to get the loaded taco fries. I tell you, this definitely has my nose running. So there's this kind of a, I can definitely taste it. It's slightly spicy. So, and it's got the red strips in there too, so you can see that. Yeah, that's good. I'd probably give this like maybe like a 7.5 out of 10, something like that. As I say, it's not bad, but I would probably prefer the loaded taco fries more, you know? I tell you, if I were to get an order at Taco Bell, my favorite item from there is the Crunchwrap Supreme. And followed closely behind their tacos. Now, I love the crunchy tacos, but they can be pretty messy. I also love their beefy 5-layer burrito. That's actually Chuck's favorite item, by the way. He likes the burrito. So, that makes some really good items. I've actually been seeing in the news lately for Taco Bell, they're testing out some new items in, I think, Chicago and stuff. And a while back, they actually brought back their spicy potato items as well. Very good. Oh, I'm tasting nacho cheese sauce. It's so good. So like, yeah, they came back out with these items. They got the nacho fries back. I always loved, did love the nacho fries. Because they've been so long since I've had the nacho fries. And yeah, they're just really the perfect accompaniment with the cheese sauce. So it's really, really glad they brought them back. Now, I also did mention to you guys in the drive-thru as well that I brought some of these delicious peaches with me, and I'll tell you the story quickly behind how I got them, and I wanted to review them. Now, yesterday, my family and I, we went out to a local orchard in Millington, Tennessee called Jones Orchard, and they have a peach orchard as well. And we went there a few months ago and we picked some strawberries, but the peaches are in season right now, and those don't look good, so I'm gonna give them a shot. Super sweet. Now these are actually called Ambrosia peaches. Very sweet. And one thing we have used them for lately is we've actually made a peach cobbler with them. Okay. These are perfect. So I don't know if you guys are like big fans of peaches or whatnot, but if you want to check out peaches in Tennessee, I'd go to Millington and check out Jones Orchard. So we must have picked about, I want to say, 8 to 9 pounds of peaches yesterday. And I got a lot of good photos and stuff. All right. Peach. Oh, I remember also growing up, my mamaw, she had like some fruit trees in her backyard, and one of them was a peach tree. And no, she made pear preserves because she had pear trees too, but she also made peach preserves, and they were really good. So if I had to rate these, I'd say like 8.5, 9 out of 10. I love them. I could eat them all day. One more. Oh, well, guys, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and I may try out some new Taco Bell items. And if you haven't done so already, be sure to click that red button down below to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell recently notifications. And I will see you guys in the next video. This is Crystal signing off. Bye, birdies!